episode 2928, I Shall Not Want.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy every day. I hope you're having a time of restoration for your body physically and also spiritually. Today is Sweet Spirit Sunday, and I really want you to focus on what God has in store for you, and I want you to take time to hear from Him. I shall not want. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, just as a reminder, we have a brand new TV show. We're partnering with Pray.com, so head on over there. It's every Tuesday morning at 10:30 a.m. Central Standard Time, 11:30 a.m. Eastern, and 8:30 a.m. Pacific. Regardless of where you are today, the situation that confines you, or circumstance that celebrates you, life is never easy. So proclaim today, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The 23rd Psalm is one that has always been a place of refuge for me from anything happening in my life, good, bad, ugly. It's just when I go to read it, just the first line, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Maybe you are trying to find refuge from being a people pleaser. Maybe you're living a life of worldly desires, not heavenly driven. Maybe you tend to react and respond from a scarcity mindset. Abundance is just not in your vocabulary. Maybe you're trapped in a corner of loneliness. Nobody sees me, nobody hears me, nobody knows I exist. Maybe you're just looking at life and you're just not good enough. You might be trying to cling more to the flesh and not what God wants for you. You might be running just to run. You could be trying to find that refuge by making decisions based on previous failures, not successes. Maybe you fear more than you trust. Your vision is limited compared to God's vision. But it's unfortunate because that's what we see. And what we see is what we act upon. And that's where we need to allow God to step in. We need to allow Him to walk with us. We need to be in step with Him and taste the goodness of God. I want to read to you Psalm 23. Just take a moment and let it just sink in, not just in your mind, but in your heart and in your spirit. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For Thou art with me, Thy rod and Thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. David knew the responsibilities and the importance of being a shepherd. He was one. He was a meek shepherd who would care for his flock. And that's how he saw God for himself. God was his shepherd, a provider, a protector, a potter. A shepherd cares, right, for his sheep, gathers them no matter what, good, bad, or ugly. When the storms come, he makes sure he finds shelter. When there's a drought, he still finds water. When one is lost, he goes to find the one. He creates nothing out of something. He feeds and waters the sheep. He fulfills their needs. That, my friend, is how David saw God, as his shepherd. And even in the darkest times, he knew in his heart that God walked with him. Never did he have to fear. Never did he have to be alone. Draw near to God. Now, I know that's easier said than done. because we get wrapped up in our own calendars, our own to-do lists, our own responsibilities. We get wrapped up in, well, our own unrealistic expectations of what the world wants from us. And that's where our focus goes. We think accolades and achievements and trophies are everything. Promotions, not that they're not. Those are good things. But if our focus is only that, we may miss the blessings. Draw near to God in the good, the bad, and the ugly. I promise you, He's watching out for you always, regardless of where you are today. So my prayer for you, may your days be blessed by the power and presence of our Lord. May your flames of greatness grow hotter as the temptations of fears and failures are reduced to ashes. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed week. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.